I think this is the best thing for French bread pizzas. They fit perfectly and they work out pretty good.
Right. Hi everyone, welcome back to my next video. Today we are talking to Tim again. We've shot a bunch of videos with Tim because he knows a lot about a lot of things. And today we're talking about cooking. I'm doing a cooking series, and Tim is using this really nice Roadpro oven. And I've had one and owned one for several years, and I love them. But Tim, what's your reaction to the Roadpro oven?
I really like it. I think it's great that you can just plug it into your vehicle, throw a couple hot dogs in there, a little bit of chili on top, and an hour later, you got yourself lunch.
Yeah.
As long as you got your car running. I don't recommend using this on a car that's sitting still, not running, because it will run your battery down. Or if you have a solar system, like I do, it works great.
Yeah, I think they draw, it's a cigarette lighter plug. So it's just a regular old cigarette lighter plug. They work the best while you're driving.
Yes.
So you're driving a long distance, you plug it in, man, it works great.
I think this is the best thing for French bread pizzas. They fit perfectly and they work out pretty good.
Right. And it kind of browns them a little bit, at least.
A little bit, but not much, but it does crisp up the bread,
right,
which helps a lot.
Right. Let's open it up and show people what it looks like. It's not huge, but it's plenty.
This will fit a rotisserie chicken from Walmart or any, you know, those $5 chickens. It'll fit in there perfectly. And I'll buy them at the store. I'll be hungry when I get there. But then I stop somewhere to get something to eat on the way home, and the chicken just goes into the cooler. But the next day, I put the whole chicken container, everything in here, close it, and about an hour and a half later, you got a steaming hot chicken.
Right.
It's good food.
Great idea. Something I've always liked to do is like buy a lasagna, frozen lasagna. Stouffer's is my favorite. And you throw, I let them thaw. You buy it in the morning, you let it thaw, you put that in there, half an hour, you got a great hot lasagna.
Yes.
And you mentioned French bread pizzas. Stouffer is my favorite of that.
Exactly.
They're my favorite. But almost any frozen dinner you can put in there. Is it hard to clean?
No. I found out that just water and paper towels. And I've been using this for about 6 months. And you can see it's still presentable.
Right. And one of the things I like to do with it is line it with aluminum foil. And then just take the aluminum foil, throw it away. That's what I almost always do.
Good idea.
I'll give it some spray, you know, the Pam. I'll spray it with Pam so it won't stick. And that's how I usually wash them. They also make one of the small loaf pans that will plop right in there. Same thing. You put your food in there and you throw it away. So no cleaning whatsoever. And I really like that. And so do you remember about how much these were?
I believe these were about $25.
Yep. And where did you get it?
Truck stop. Most truck stops have your 12-volt accessories for the truck drivers.
Right.
But also us nomads use them also.
Oh, yeah, all the time. Yeah. So any truck stop will have it, and Amazon will have it. I'll leave a link down in the description below. Have you ever done this? You buy the tube of cookies, cookie dough. Uh-huh. And you just slice them up, and I put them on aluminum foil.
Okay.
And then they'll cook up nice.
Oh, I'll have to try that. Yeah. I have not tried that yet.
And you can buy them tubes of brownies. Any of the tubes will do nicely in there.
Okay.
And like you said, they don't brown perfectly, but they do brown a little. So it's good. The heat's all on the bottom. There's no heat on the top.
Oh, okay.
That's why you don't get much browning on the top. But they do get nice and warm and hot in there. I've also made cornbread mix. I like cornbread. And so I've made cornbread and put it in an aluminum foil pan and made an aluminum foil tray out of it and put it in there. And again, it doesn't brown perfectly, but it's good. It's very good. I buy a Jiffy mix and make a couple of doses of it, do it twice so I get a whole thing of Jiffy mix. Lots of things you can do with this. It's just almost anything you can do with an oven, you can do with it. It'll just take a long time.
It takes a lot longer.
Yeah. Their draw is about 10 amps. I think it's about the max of what you can get out of the cigarette lighter plug, probably about 10 amps. So if you do a cook for an hour, you're probably looking at about 10 amps out of your battery, I would say at the most. And most times, 30 to 45 minutes will do it, so even less than 10 amps. It's not a real unreasonable draw. If you have a 100 amp hour battery, which most of us do, that's 10% of your battery. If you do it sometime early in the day, so on a sunny day, so that the sun has plenty of time to recharge off solar, you can use this right off solar, no problem. I've had these for a long time. Now I have a microwave, and I find with the microwave, I use it so much that I stopped carrying one. But I do love these things. They work really, really well.
They really do. Yeah. These are great.
Yeah. So, folks, there you have it. Another great tip on how to have your best life on wheels. And you got to cook, you got to eat, and this will really, really help. Do you think this would be worth $25 to you? Leave a comment below. Would you spend $25? I would, and I recommend it. But let us know what you think. Please hit the subscribe button. There's nothing you can do that will help me more than hitting the subscribe button. Hit the thumbs up button if you like the video, and we'll talk to you later.